Welcome back to another game review. I'm Vice President of Medieval Cheese Distribution, Fat Caddington, broadcasting strong here on Frag Nation. Diving in, we are reviewing the game Battle Brothers. This is an open-world tactics RPG that is set in medieval times. Developed and published by Overhype Studios, it was released in April of 2015. In this game, you will be commanding a group of four higher mercenaries that look more adorable than threatening. I mean, look at me. Look like one of those Russian dolls that open and smaller versions pop out. That aside, let's take a look at what makes this game surprisingly great. The first topic, as usual, is gameplay. It features a top-down, turn-based tactics view where you will look to defeat your foes through your cunning use of not dying. You'll start with your beginning group, and you will have the option to hire more mercenaries right away or wait until later. Once you are set with the mercenaries you wish to lead to their doom, you may want to equip them with gear. There is no restriction on what people can use. This way you can make anybody do what you need them to do. By having different weapons equipped, you will be able to perform different skills and have better strengths against enemy defenses. It's one thing to have the best gear, but you'll want to be stronger too. Each character stats are randomized, and some even come with traits like nearsightedness or past professions that strengthen certain skills. After combat, you will gain experience and thus be able to level up. Leveling allows you to raise your stats like ranged combat ability or even your resolve. It also allows you to pick perks that boost certain aspects of your combat to make you stronger in whatever you see fit. Now all that was just character stuff. During a fight, you'll be placed on a random map. These maps, as you would expect, will be vastly different and offer a variety of obstacles to work around. You will have to play smart, which could be challenging for some of you out there. Between fights, you will be spending most of your time traveling. And then after where you get to where you're going, you'll turn around and travel some more. Now, while it may seem really boring, it actually makes a lot of sense for the game's features. There's no magic healing bandage that you can just put on and boom, you're healed 100 hit points. You have medicine, you have tools to repair with, and you have to have the time to actually do those things. So it's no longer just an instantaneous thing, you have to actually let your players heal and repair their weapons. So after battles that you fail to keep the blood inside of you, it will take some time to heal and repair. Plan accordingly. Also, those mercenaries that you travel with are kind of greedy. You have to feed and pay them on top of keeping them alive. Travel to different towns for quests and chances to earn some gold. All this to be the fiercest mercenary band, of course. Continue to travel and become the strongest, because if you die, it's game over. Permadeath. And don't be one of those save scummy people who save right before each battle and just go back if they didn't win. We know if you did. On to the technicals, of course. Graphics. It just works. The art style is great. The battle maps and the world maps are fantastic to see and explore. Even with my comment on the character design earlier, it actually still works with the game and looks really nice. Audio is actually surprisingly strong in this game as well. The music is very good and never lets up with keeping you in the moment. Even the sound effects are neatly done, so that way it's just not as boring to hear the same clanking of metal all the time. Now, my complaints are few, but nevertheless, there are some. One, it is very difficult to learn right off the bat. Not exactly something that you'll just pick up and play right away unless you've played it before. I would recommend checking out the developer's YouTube channel for tutorials if you need some help. The next complaint is that there isn't a whole lot of direction sometimes. As it is just open world and free roam, you pick and choose where you want to go and what quests to take, so you may not exactly know what you want to do next sometimes. Lastly, the game is in early access, so it's not technically done at the moment. Overall, this game is solid and pretty fun. I would definitely recommend getting this game if you enjoy tactics games. With an overall score of an 8.4, you'll want to gather your merry men and die repeatedly. As always, I'm Fat Caddington here on Frag Nation.